properties with Fannie Mae, and they've never inspected the property once for habitability or safety. And there's over 30 violations wrong with the place. They came out recently and told us we had 60 days to leave. And this is after we built bunk beds for homeless people. And it's just ridiculous. We have to go to court soon and go to trial against Fannie Mae just to try to get them to give us another year lease or give us 6 months to switch, you know, to a different men's home. We're a nonprofit. We don't have a 501c3 because we can't afford $900. And it sucks that you have to pay money to get a break in life. But the government here has threatened to arrest me for opening a homeless shelter. They threatened to arrest me for opening an education center here because of the zoning. They told me if I open it in zoning that's not intensive use zoning, that I could go to jail. And so I went around and I looked at the city map at every spot that had intensive use zoning, and I figured out that there's not one spot in the city of Vallejo that you can open a homeless shelter. You have to build it from the ground up. There's no spot that the city provides legally to open a homeless shelter. The Christian Help Center only has 60 spots for men, women, and children, and they're getting ready, rumor has it that they're getting ready to remodel. They're going to be temporarily shut down. So back when the tsunami hit Japan, I gathered about 1,000 pounds of supplies. I had a church in Tokyo that was waiting for me, and Japanese Airlines said, all you got to do is get a government to inspect your supplies and we'll give you a free ride over. Well, I called the city of Vallejo after the Time Standard came out and took photos of all of our supplies, and I told the city of Vallejo what was going on, and the city attorney said we do not deal with humanitarian issues. And they
like our administration.
They denied the inspection, and I was planning on going over there and establishing a lot of video and a lot of photographs and establishing volunteer teams to continue to go back to Japan to this day. Those dreams are ruined along with the 40 churches that denied me. I'm a Christian. I believe in Jesus Christ. I go to a few churches in town, but I just don't agree with the body of Christ here in Vallejo. After that mission, I set up a table on Sonoma and Indiana Street, and that's where Samson's unit became. We started feeding crack cocaine addicts, prostitutes, Bloods Mafia members, pimps, the homeless, everybody out there. We started basically just loving these people. We would order about 13 pizzas, and we would order a lot of water, and we would go out there and we would love these people.
Folks, the way we're working it is informal. Step on up and say your piece, okay?
So yeah, as I mentioned, my name is Alex Shantz, and I am a co-coordinator for the Napa County Green Party, and I'm also a student, and I'm here to show solidarity as a Green and a student with all of the 99% here in Vallejo and across the globe. As we all know, today is International Workers Day, and students, along with working class people everywhere, are under attack. The promise of free and accessible higher education is being dismantled. Students are being denied a college education due to fee hikes, fee and tuition hikes, reduced course offerings, and limited student services. Within the community college system, students are facing, due in part to the Student Success Task Force, less financial aid opportunities, less time to explore their academic interests, and less access to higher education in general.
I mean, because they say that they have no control over the banks and the major economic interests here in town. Well, actually, they do. If we look at the recent November elections, we will see a real estate eviction lawyer won over a banker. Now, I need only tell you they represent each one of them, the interest of the 1% versus the interest of the 99%. For the cost of two of those palm trees out here in River Park, for each one of those palm trees cost approximately $40,000. Just two palm trees, and you could probably buy many of these foreclosed on properties. It would be easy to go get a nonprofit to come in terms of directed group collective home and provide housing for the homeless for two of those palm trees. Now the city says it has no money, yet it has a lot of palm trees. This, and in many other ways, points to the problem that is not only international, national, but it's also local here in Scope. We have to look at creative problems to benefit the overwhelming majority of people who live here in Vallejo, rather than the narrow interest of the downtown banks, the development corporations, the various large merchants that ordinarily control city politics.
Labor, students, community, unite. Solidarity is key in the answer to our problems, right?
I would tell you this much. We're all different. We come from a multi-culture, but here we stand united in this plurinational state of California. We all believe in some kind of America, and it is America that upholds human rights. Yes, freedom of speech, solidarity with all people around the world. Yes, this is the kind of America we want to stand for. This is what the Occupy movement's all about. And as we strive to uphold human rights and civil rights, we all understand that this Occupy movement is our new civil rights movement.
Hey everybody, I just want to let you know, as we are here gathered, there is a foreclosure auction taking place in the corner. They actually moved into a small shady corner back there. This is where they're auctioning off foreclosed properties all over Solano County, right here on the steps. You ever seen the Michael Moore movie Capitalism, where they have the condo vulture? It's kind of like that. Could I get a few shame on yous from the crowd?
Shame on you!
Hands off our homes.
If anybody's got a lot of control over redevelopment in Vallejo, there's a lot to say about what the screw goes on in this city. It's got to be George S. Miller in Washington, D.C. And the man had decided to join the establishment, I don't know when, the 80s, the 90s. But he's definitely part of it. He doesn't draw his own districts, but he's got a lot of power. And I think that Vallejo ought to lean on him if they possibly can. That's all I
want. Be one of the progressive voices. For instance, I thought of, we're always hearing from the Democratic voice machine, hardworking middle-class families. If I hear that one more time, I can quit. They are working and or challenging people, including LGBT rights. Oh, one more thought. You're looking for a spiritual movement with no dogma, but fights very hard for single-payer, climate change, immigrant rights, and LGBTQ, which stands for questioning rights. Check out Unitarian Universalists. There's one in Napa, there's a local meeting once a month here. They've been to 200 or 300. They're the abolitionists, the suffragists, civil rights workers, Unitarian Universalists. They're wonderful. Show up with this local stuff. It's how to think globally and act locally. And good luck and happy May Day.
I just wanted to say, I'm 67 years old, and I believe that the rebuild the American dream is so important, because I grew up in the American dream, and I had it. And when I got out of the Navy, I got a job. I got a job where I could support myself, support my family. I got two cars. It was an average job. I went to college on the GI Bill. I later went to college, and like somebody else said earlier, it was free. At one time, we had the American dream. And rich people were rich then. They weren't just average people. They were rich people. But they wanted to get richer. And so they beat the unions down. It started with the air traffic controllers. And it just went on and on from there. And it's gotten to the point now where if we don't support our unions, there will be no more unions. And whether you work for a union or not, your wages are there because of that union. And so we have to support our unions every time. We have to be out there, and we have to help them, and we can't cross picket lines.
Yeah.
How long have you been involved with Occupy Oakland, and what do you hope to see it achieve here?
Well, on and off since the beginning of the thing. I've been to most of the actions. I've helped out a little with one or two of the committees.
Seeing all the problems in our society, I'm seeing living standards melt away, the schools, a young generation that doesn't seem to have anything to hope for or waiting for them at the other end. And I'm talking about the people that follow all the rules. So I'll answer your first question, is what I hope comes out of this is a mass movement to actually completely change this system to something that is friendly to working people. It's friendly to everyone.
I've been somewhat involved with Occupy Oakland over the course of the fall, especially, and I was drawn in by the experience of coming to Oscar Grant Plaza and having dialogues with a lot of people from all over Oakland about kind of what should be changed both locally and nationally.
What do you hope to see Occupy achieve?
Actually, for me, Occupy is more interesting not as a movement about goals, but as a movement about practices. I think the most exciting thing that Occupy has already achieved is bringing people together to have conversations across difference. And I think that Occupy's strength is that it's open-ended, and that as soon as it closes its goals to be about a certain end, that it won't be as exciting or flexible.
Oakland is one of the major points for the distribution of goods and the kind of an industrial hub as well. So we're workers. I'm a blue-collar worker. And to defend ourselves against austerity, Oakland made the shot over the bow and announced America's not going to take it, just like Greece ain't taking it, just like Italy isn't taking it. We're not going to take it. So May Day is when we remind ourselves to be human. You got to fight for your wage and fight for like something better than a wage. Everything to be fair.
Well, I think what's making a big difference is the crisis. The crisis of the system is what's really making everybody get active and get in motion. All these foreclosures, people losing their jobs, and all the brutality and all of that. It's police brutality, police violence, police misconduct. We could go on and on about that. But the brutality in our communities and in our world is what is the main problem as far as our lives and our health and our safety.
I think it's a good thing that they got a lot of the people out together. You know, you finally get to see all the races getting along with one another. You know, you got the kids, the people. It's a good thing.
What do you think of the march here today? I think it's great. Great. Should be more union members down here.
One last thing. Where are you coming out here from? Are you from Oakland yourself?
I used to live in Oakland 10, 15 years ago. I moved out in the valley.
What do you hope or think that the Occupy movement could change, or what are its, where do you see it going?
I think it could change maybe the overall individualism that's kind of plagued our society, because people are starting to understand that we need each other, and like this movement is that opportunity for people to come together and like start to find some common ground, I guess.
What brings you to the rally in Oakland today?
It's May Day. It's International Workers' Day. This is what's happening. I think that it looks like the beginning of something that could be really incredible. Something that, you know, it's the very beginning of it, so I don't want to get ahead of myself. But this is how it starts. When the big changes happen, this is how it starts. Affiliated with it. We've gotten a lot of trash in the media, and almost none of it's deserved. Occupy doesn't do everything perfectly, but what does? You know, we've done a lot of good that they don't get in. You know, the press doesn't cover it all. And I'm hoping it can be a focal point for people to kind of fight to change the system, and that the militancy of Occupy leaks out into the rest of society, into the schools and the unions and the workplaces.